Yes! Hell yeah! Yeah, it's over with another fine beer. Yeah, I'm ready to do another video. Let me get a drink of this real quick. God, that's good. Whew. Yeah, it's another one of them hot summer days. You know, I'm kind of mad at the sun. I had enough of it, man. I mean, I appreciate it because it's the 4th of July tomorrow, Independence Day. America's 239th birthday. Got to celebrate. I'll be drinking beer tomorrow. I can tell you that much right now. But there, I'm drinking beer now. Yeah, but I'm back to open some more Yu-Gi-Oh! Today, God, it's hot. I don't understand. Oh my God. Anyways, I got a box of Cross Souls. Yep. It's probably one of my favorite boxes of all time. I don't know why. I really like the boxes they've come out ever since the new, what is it, Arc V? I like the new series. I don't watch the show. I haven't watched Yu-Gi-Oh! I quit watching Yu-Gi-Oh! Back in like GX, like halfway through GX. I'm just not into cartoons. And anyways, what I'm hoping to get out of this is, of course, lose one turn. Galaxy Cyclone. Galaxy Cyclone's the big one out of this one now. Ghost Ogre. El Shaddaa Anatolis, I think you pronounce it, whatever the hell the water one's called. And, oh, my phone's ringing. That's nice. I wonder who that is. Well, let me take a look here. That's this interruption. It's very rude. I don't know. Whoa, Jesus. Oh, my God. I almost, like, flipped this chair over. Anyways, damn phone. I don't know who it is. Caller ID just says cell phone. Well, there's like 300 billion cell phones. I mean, more cell phones than people in the world. Won't make any damn sense, but that's the way it works. I didn't know to drink my beer. Oh. The beer is trying to cool me down, but it's just hot. Anyways, I'm going to open this up and get to opening some packs. But, yeah, Cross Souls, it's kind of a stupid name. I don't really like, I know why it's called Cross Souls. It's called Cross Souls because of the new, Zexal monsters, I think. But, yeah, I think that's the deal. But I don't really like the name Cross Souls. I like, you know, Duelist Alliance sounds cool. New Challenger sounds like something out of Street Fighter, which I like Street Fighter, so I'm down with that. Seekers of Eternity was one of the cooler names. I think I like Extreme Victory. I don't know why. Extreme Victory's always been one of my favorites. Generation 4 sounds cool. But alright, enough of that. I'll get into opening. Again, lose one turn, Galaxy Cyclone, Ghost Ogre. That's about all I can think of right now. Man, it's hot. Raid Raptor. I watched a guy yesterday at Locals open like 9 packs of Cross Soul, I think. And I think he got this out of 9 packs. I think he got it like 4 times. This Blaze Falcon. It's hilarious. But anyways, yeah, the 4th is tomorrow. I'm going to have some fireworks. Apparently, it's like the driest it's ever been. And, hopefully, in honor of George Washington and all those guys, I don't start a forest fire. If I do, Meliodas Maestra. Nobody uses the Meliodas cards. This is the best card for, Fiend Griefing is by far the best support Burning Abyss has gotten in a long time. This card is incredibly good. I run Burning Abyss. It's my favorite deck to play. I went to Locals yesterday, went 3-1. I beat round one. I can never remember what the hell I beat. I remember what I lose to. I always remember that. What did I beat? Damn it! It's gonna come back to me. But round one, I beat something. Oh, Burning Abyss. Duh, I had a Burning Abyss mirror match. I won that. Round two, I had Stellar Knights. Round three was Evil Swarm. Round four, I lost to Quillforts. I could not get around. Quillforts are so broken a lot of times. I hate Pendulum Summoning. Look there, we got a Raid Raptor Falcon. Nobody uses that crap. This is like, I think this is the worst Zephyr monster. Zephyr Core. I've only ran into Zephyrs like in real life. I think I ran them once, and I think I lost. It was like Teller Knight Zephyrs. It was really good, but online I play against them. I usually beat them. They just, I don't know. The only Pendulum one they seem to get going is Quillfort, and that deck is way too good still. I mean, I could not beat it yesterday. I tried everything that Burning Abyss can do. And, oh, look at that. There's a Shifeng. Xiaofeng. Phantom of the Yang Xing. This is a pretty cool-looking card, honestly. I've always liked Synchro, like, in terms of, like, the color around them. I like the white. That's not white supremacy. I don't want to get anybody thinking about that, okay? Just, no. No white supremacy there. No Heil Hitler. But anyways, yeah, that's a good looking monster. 2,800 attack, big monster. And, you know, it's good. I've played running against this. You can't activate monster effects with the same attribute as the ones that were attributed or synchro material for this. And then I got Barbar. Barbar is another great support, I think, because I run two of them in my Burning Abyss deck. And what I do with them is, one, he's 1,700 attack. I got over a Denko Sekka one time just because of Barbar. Just normal Barbar and just slammed into it. And then I did 900 damage to the guy and killed his Denko and then all my traps were free. So Barbar is a great monster. You're always milling. Whenever he goes in the grave, always use it. Even if it's only 300, just do it. You know, because you always want to get closer and closer. You're getting down to zero, of course. And then with Barbar, you can get him with Nightmare Shark. So direct attack for 2,000. So that's cool. Got a super. It's actually a good super, I think. I don't know if it's worth anything, but it's definitely better than like a Fright for Leo, you know. That's another one, that guy. He got 9 packs, right, and he got 2 Fright for Leos. He did get an El Shaddoll Anatolis, so he kind of made up there. I'm going to have another sip of my beer. That's good. Anyways, going back in. Let's see here. So I got a super. Man, it's hot. I can't stand it. Another rank up. More Raid Raptor support. Nobody plays this crap. Who plays Raid Raptor? Is it supposed to be good eventually? I doubt it. All the commas in this, except for Fiend Griefing, are relatively useless. And like, except for UA. UA got the, you got some, but nobody hardly uses UA. I run into UA a lot on Dueling Network, but never in real life. I've only played in real life twice, and I've beaten them both times. But I had Ophion on my side when I did. I've never played with anything else in real life. Alright. I didn't even notice this Raid Raptor monster before. Huh. Suture Rebirth. The Monster Reborn for, Frifers, Fluffles. So, I guess that's okay. That's one deck I always thought would be fun. See, like, a really good-looking woman at, like, a regional defeating all those fat nerds with. She's got, like, pink fingernails, pink sleeves. Her playmat's a Barbie doll, like Ken Barbie hugging. God, that'd be funny until I lose to her. I'd be like, oh, that's so funny. Like, oh, my God. No, the last regional I went to in Seattle, I had to play against one girl. The first time I ever played Yu-Gi-Oh! Against a girl in my life. And she's a good-looking woman. I mean, she ain't nothing special. She's just an attractive woman. I mean, she's just a girl. You know what I mean. But all the guys thought she was gorgeous. And her boyfriend's there, and he's a nice guy. I've talked to him, and I've played him a couple times, and I've beaten him every time. So this is the time for me to beat his woman. Not literally, but beat her in a card game, and I did it. She was running Necroz. I'm always so upset with her because she's always had the highest tier deck. I've seen her plenty of times. She's always got the high tier deck. She had Necroz, and I beat it. Yeah! And that took down Necroz. Alright. And more Fright for stuff. Fright for Fusion. This is like their Miracle Fusion that Elemental Heroes got a long time ago. Frightfurs, I'm really surprised they don't get more play. I've read them over really hardcore. And they're not a bad, card. I mean, deck type. So I don't know. They're just not. You know, they're not popular. This is a brutal card. UA penalty box. This is like Farfa on steroids. I mean, it's crazy how good that card is. UAs are completely terrifying to play against a lot of times. Now they get perfect ace, penalty box, and mighty slugger, and you're just like, I can't win. You got to get Ophion on the field. That's the way, or Vanity's Emptiness. Just or a Wenda. I've done it with a Wenda before. All right, moving on. Oh, a Medulce Pudding Princess Chocolate en Mode. Nobody uses this crap. I don't know why this was ever printed. Like, Medulce's, I don't even think would use this. Does it have? I guess it's got an okay Medulce effect. And I got this, whatever the hell that is. Again, no one's going to put this in a Yosenju deck. Are you insane? I could see maybe one in the extra deck for Medulce, but again, they're mainly going for Levier, the Sea Dragon, and stuff like that. But, yeah, there's an Ultra Rare. That's cool. That thing looks like a truck engine. It was supposed to be a bunch of chains together. Half unbreak. Huh. But yeah, let's see what kind of festivities are going around here in my small woodsy mountain town of Kanasket, Ravensdale, Kanasket. None. We're just hoping nobody burns down the forest. This old growth forest I live in. The city I go to play the locals, Renton, they call themselves Tree City USA. I don't know why. I don't have a clue why Renton calls itself Tree City USA. It's really annoying. But they have a sign every fourth that says no fireworks allowed in Tree City USA. It should say, instead of Tree City, they should say Communist City USSR. I get tired of not being able to have fireworks everywhere. I mean, I can shoot fireworks all I want. It's legal where I'm at, where my parents are at. I mean, it's like 20 square miles around me where it's legal to have fireworks. So that sucks for Renton and Auburn. Sea Dragons, Sea Dragoons of Draconia, that's the sneak peek card. I actually have it. Another Fiend Griefing. I got to reach around my beer here. There it is. There's a sneak peek version. The Ultra. I wonder if they're actually going to make that a good set. The normal Pendulum, like a decent archetype. I doubt it, just because, it's Pendulum Monsters. I mean, normal monsters. And Pendulum Monsters. All right. People say I talk too much, but you know what? Talk is cheap. I think that's a good thing. This is one of the better Stellar Knight monsters, Zephyrus Cydon. It's pretty cool. Another Fiend Griefing. Got a playset. Not even halfway through the box. Fiend Griefing's so good. I was using it against Stellar Knights yesterday. I destroyed the Stellar Knight and this Evil Swarm guy. But I was never in any sort of danger versus them. I mean, the guy never even hurt me once with Stellar Knights. And, it was just, that breakthrough skill, Fiend Griefing, just everything. He randomly mind crushed me. He was like, sir, I didn't have a sir. And then I got to discard one of his cards. It was great. Like, why would you pick sir anyway? I'm just going to use this effect. Unexpected die. In Japan, this was an unexpected guy. I don't know what good this would do. It's not even, if this was a spell speed 2, it would be more playable, but it's just a spell speed 1, so I don't know what you do with this. Look at that thing. Performful Elahammer. Such a hilarious looking monster. 2600 attack is a lot for a... But this is the worst archetype I've ever seen. Performapol. It's so bad. Like, it's so incredibly bad. This is what I'm talking about. It's the deck's so bad, it actually lets you reshuffle your hand and draw a card. I mean, that's unheard of. Oh, man. But, yeah. Okay. This heat's really... I'm just soaked in sweat. I mean, wow, that pack got ripped up. Yeah. Magma Dragon. It's pretty cool looking. Void Purification. Phantom Griffin. 2000 attack, Vanilla Beater. Huh. That's like Griffin's Feather Duster. I think that's what it's supposed to be the wings are. Void Purification. I heard Inferno is supposed to be really good coming up. Maybe not. They got that new monster where they can come and normal summon it. It's the only Inferno monster you just can be normal summoned. And then it's a tuner, too, I believe. And they have a new Synchro Infernoid monster coming. And if I remember, that's really good, too. So maybe Infernoids... I hate playing Infernoids. They're always banishing everything, getting off the field. They're crazy. But, you know, I would have played them, but they were fire type. I only played dark types. I did play Quillfort for like 3 weeks, and I played Stellar Knights once, and I just didn't feel good because I wasn't playing a dark type. I felt like I was betraying myself, you know? You don't want to. Sorry, I just drank some of my beer. But you don't want to betray yourself. Looks like something Godzilla would like to step on. Oh, look how many feet it has. I didn't realize it was like a centipede. Zephyrwindy. Ritual Beast. There's one guy at Locals who loves Ritual Beasts, and he's pretty good with it. He used to always play Infernoids, but he switched over to Ritual Beasts. And he's doing pretty well with it. He topped last Saturday, but he missed out. He didn't have the right tiebreakers to top yesterday. They want me to play on the 4th. They're actually have Locals on the 4th of July, but I'm not going to go. I mean, the 4th of July is for family and fireworks and stuff like that. And, you know, I can go play Yu-Gi-Oh! Every Saturday besides the 4th, unless I'm working or got other commitments. But I'm usually there every Saturday, so I'm not going to show up the 4th. I mean, it's a holiday, for crying out loud. Alrighty. And a Fright First Sheep, a super rare. What's this effect? It comes back. It's like kind of like Evil Swarm Thunderbird. Destroyed by a postcard. You spell summon this card if you do a game anywhere. It'll be 2800 attack after it dies and comes back. That's pretty good. I know this is like the better one out of. I know Leo's all right too. I mean, again, I think the Fright Furs are not a bad deck type. I think they could do some serious damage to people who weren't suspecting. There's another Fright Fur Factory. Oh, a Dante, Pilgrim of the Burning Abyss, a secret rare. There we go. Nobody uses this card, but man, it's kind of cool looking. I don't really like his armor. I don't really like his stuff, his staff and everything. I was really hoping that instead of another Dante, I was hoping they were going to do his wife. I can't remember his wife's name. She's in the ritual card or whatever. Not ritual. Terminus of the Burning Abyss. And I really thought she was going to be it, but they picked Dante again. And it's too bad that ever since Virgil came out, the two big boss monsters, Malakota and Dante Pilgrim, remember John Wayne always saying Pilgrim? He'd like grimace while he walked. And, you know, John Wayne hated Indians. There ain't an Indian worth a damn in any John Wayne movie. They're always out doing bad things, you know. Maybe there's a good scout once in a while, but they never trust him. But anyways, Virgil was the last good boss monster. I love Virgil. I use Virgil all the damn time. And, it's too bad. This card has potential, but it's just, if it just said 3 Burning Abyss monsters, not 3 different Burning Abyss monsters, this card would be just amazing. But you need to have 3 different ones from your field or hand, and it's just, that's too difficult. You know? I mean, I was doing it online, and when I got Dante Pilgrim on the field, I usually won. I mean, he's tough to get rid of. But he's also tough. Excuse me. He's also tough to get. Alright. That's cool. I got the secret. Look at this stupid ass card. But anyways, moving on. Another Raid Raptor. That thing's giving like the Heil Hitler. That's not good. Heil! Heil myself. I wonder if Hitler ever did. He looked in the mirror and gave himself a Heil. He probably did. I mean, why not? But yeah, getting back to those Indians in the John Wayne movie, they made them look dumb. Like, they didn't even have to, like, shoot at Indians. In the corner of the John Wayne movies, you could have just left Indians in, like, a room, and they wouldn't be able to find their way out because there's doors, and they don't know how to use a doorknob. You know, they might, you know, lick it or stare at it, but they ain't going to know what to do. I mean, there's something the Indians are good at that John Wayne wasn't good at, like shooting a bow and arrow. John Wayne, you know, he couldn't shoot a bow and arrow. He could shoot a gun, but not a bow and arrow. And also, the Indians, you know, they were good with, like, plants. You know, they you get a cut or a burn on your arm, and they go rub some green paste on it and get me feeling good pretty soon. Another raid raptor. These things are like a plague in these things. I mean, I don't mind getting them. It's just like, wow. Every pack, almost, you get a raid raptor rare. It didn't seem that way in Duelist Alliance with the Burning Abyss. I mean, there's three Burning Abyss rare monsters in there. And it doesn't seem like they come up that often. As many as there are. And I think there's three in each set. Suture Rebirth. They're such cool looking monsters, but the Infernal and Fiend Griefing. Great card. I wish it was a super, though. Hopefully it'll be reprinted as a super in an Astral pack. I'd like that a lot. Let's see here. At least it's a good, easy card to get. I mean, I've already gotten like five or six of them. Look at this thing. It's wearing like a vest. What? Is that not a vest? It's like a big coil around it. Look at its little hat. Oh, that's hilarious. Oh, that's a great looking card. It's useless, but I love the artwork on it. Look at that. What's his name? Lord of D. Lord of D just rivaling Virgil. I mean, Virgil's still way cool looking, way better card. But Lord of D, kind of a dirty name. Lord of D, yep. That sounds like a good adult film almost. Lord of, maybe, I don't know. I don't think I'd like, wow. We'll leave it there. But anyways, yeah, it was hilarious playing the Burning Abyss mirror match yesterday. I hate doing it, and the guy I was playing against, he hated it too. And I've played him many a times, and me and him don't really get along. But it felt so good beating him. I took the Maxi challenge, let him draw seven cards. And then I flipped over, like, Vanny's Emptiness, and he couldn't do anything. And then I just won free game. He beat me game one. I don't remember how, but he came from behind and got me. Game two and three, I got him. But game three took, I mean, it was really intense. I don't know which Edge Imp is the best one. I think it's still Sabers, I think. I think this is the worst one. Tomahawk? I don't remember. I'll have to read them all again. The hell is that? I don't know. This card's ridiculous. I've played against that a few times. Trap Monster Deck. I should be getting one more Ultra Rare out of this box, I think. You know, this is a hilarious looking card here. I mean, this is one of my favorite artworks I've seen in a while. It's just like, look how, it's like Johnny Cage from Mortal Kombat. I mean, and who the hell is that? Is that like Kozuki? I got two Madolte Princesses Chocolate en Mode. Can you believe that? There's the Ultra Rare, and it's another Madolte Princess. Or Pudding Sis. And I got the sneak peek. What the hell? I am so good at that, like getting the same cards over and over again. I mean, sometimes it really works out. Another Fiend Griefing. Sometimes it really works out, though. You know, oh, my phone's buzzing. But, sorry about that. That other phone going off, my regular landline. I think I'm one of the last people my age to have a landline. I mean, most people don't even have that, but I like the landline. Now, Edge and Saw. Junk Anchor and Zephra Divine Strike. This is a pretty good card for Zephras. They do have to banish one from their extra deck, but, you know, it's a counter. It's a spell or trap or monster effect, so it's pretty good. It's pretty good. I mean, in some ways, it's almost better than Solemn Warning, because, like, Solemn Warning is weak against, like, Black Rose Garden, or whatever the hell his name is. Like, well, you can't do anything. You gotta hit that with an MST. You cannot Solemn Warn that, even though it special summons a monster. It's kind of a joke. Alright. Another Melodus Maestra. Wide Hips. Look at those hips. I mean, is that her legs, or is something going on? She's got like some sort of like Elephant Man syndrome. I don't know. Look at that pink fucking hippo ass. I'm sorry, I shouldn't have. I should watch my language. I'm sorry about that. I'm sorry. The beer is. Let me drink another. Get some more beer. It is the heat. The heat is making me forget what words to use. All right, last pack. Let's see if I can get another Fiend Griefing out of the last pack. Frightfur Fusion. Fiend Griefing. No, I couldn't get it. But I did get another Frightfur Fusion, which, you know, if I need to make a Frightfur deck, got all the fusions. So anyways, my big card out of that was Dante, the Pilgrim, John Wayne style. Well, hope you enjoyed this box opening. I know I did. The beer always helps, but the heat doesn't. The heat is just too much for me. But anyways, hope you guys have a good 4th. Independence Day tomorrow. Hope you guys do it safely. Don't blow off a finger. Don't blow up someone's house. Don't, you know, blow up someone's dog. Don't start a forest fire. Don't burn apartments down. Don't get too drunk. Get a little drunk, but not too drunk. You know, for those of you playing Yu-Gi-Oh! On the 4th, good luck. Hope you got more plans than just that for the 4th. And, you know, it was a pleasure opening. And I'll be back. I've got more stuff to open. I've always got Yu-Gi-Oh! To open. It's what I do. But anyways, I will catch you guys later. One final sip of beer for you on the camera. Oh, man, that helps me out. All right, guys, I'll see you around. Peace.